The Poisoned Bread by Bandhu Madhav. About the author. Bandhu Madhav was a Dalit short story writer from Maha community in Maharashtra and a Buddhist convert. He was also instrumental in founding the Little Magazine movement, which blended modernism and the Dalit movement in Marathi literature. Bandhu Madhav was also a leading writer of Prabuddha Bharat and Dharma Yana. Bandhu Madhav's language is simple, easy, and clear. This is a rural language of the downtrodden. It is not an amorous language wrapped up in delicate gossamer. It is adorned like a coarse 9-yard sari, with rough unembellished layers of genuine Marathi life. Critical analysis of The Poisoned Bread. The Poisoned Bread, by Bandhu Madhav, often included in discussions around Dalit literature, provides a stark, unflinching look into the lives of the Dalit community, focusing on their struggles, societal discrimination, and the quest for dignity within the oppressive caste system of India. Through its narrative, the story not only delves into the physical and psychological torment faced by Dalits but also critiques the societal norms that perpetuate such oppression. The anthology Poisoned Bread is a repository of the Marathi Dalit experience. The anthology Poisoned Bread is divided into 4 parts: poetry, autobiographical extracts, short stories and essays and speeches. The Poisoned Bread is about a phase beginning with an awakening amongst the Dalits and about the reaction of the upper castes against such an awakening. The upper castes took this to be a threat to their authority. The story raises a number of questions, which were crucial to Dalit consciousness. At the same time, attempts have been made to resolve those conflicts that often led to confusion amongst the youth. It is interesting to know that the story reaches a resolution towards the conclusion and in a way, the resolving points in the story pave way for the youth that often acts as a guideline. The story unfolds in a village setting where Dalits, the lowest caste in the Hindu social hierarchy, are forced to accept leftover, stale, and even poisoned bread from the higher caste community as a means of survival. The protagonist, a young Dalit man, decides to reject this demeaning form of sustenance, symbolizing a stand against the systemic oppression and inhumane treatment meted out to his community. This act of refusal is not merely about rejecting food but represents a broader rejection of the social order that deems certain humans as unworthy. The story is about a small boy who visits his village and accompanies his grandfather, 12 years back, to Bapu Patil, a village landowner, in order to work for him and beg for a larger share of, but his expectations are not met due to the fact that the narrator argues with the landowner on the pretext of the status and position of the Mahas in society when Patil humiliates him. Patil was irritated with the Dalit movements and their demands for equality. He retorts because of his own insecurity in the threat to his power in society. The very sight of the lower caste Mahas was considered to be unfortunate, and when Patil tells Yetalia this, he replies meekly, submitting to Patil as his obedient slave, "I am your begging Maha and feel proud to be so." Patil retorts to this sarcastically as, "Don't give me that line, you're no longer the Maha Mangs of the good old days, to beg for your share of the corn. You are now Harijan. You are even started claiming equality, so I was told, eating and drinking with us at the city hotels." The conflict in the story arises with the narrator's aggressive reply to Patil. The narrator represents the new force and the voice of the new generation that is more aware of its own self-respect and dignity. The narrator challenges the religious claims about the position of groups, when Patil alludes to Chikamela's position, who was a poet during Bhakti period. The narrator questions Patil, "What's this position you are talking about, Patil? And whose position?" To this, Patil delineates an order of hierarchy, stating it in the descending order, starting from the Brahmin, Maratha, fisherman, weaver, Mahamang, Doran, cobbler. The narrator professes that everyone was equal and there was hardly any difference between anyone. This seems to have been influenced by the Buddhists' doctrine of religion. Dr. Ambedkar, in his essay, Buddha or Karl Marx, spells out the Buddhist doctrine of equality in religion as he emphasizes that all human beings are equal. Worth and not birth is the measure of man. What is important is high ideals and not noble birth. This incident raises a debate around issues about religion and the function of religion, particularly in context of Hinduism, which professes caste divisions. The grandfather and the grandson work for the whole day tilling the soil, but Patil doesn't pay them anything in return. The grandfather collects the stale breadcrumbs lying near the pen, which the cows had refused to eat. On their way back home, the grandson and grandfather share the experience of exploitation met by the Dalits at the hand of the landowners. The grandfather expresses his feelings as, "Will the Mahas and Mangs never be happy? What a humiliating life we live. Do you think I feel happy about being oppressed by the landlords and the rest of the villagers? I too want to retaliate and have a good fight for the humiliation and injustice they have been piling upon us. I am helpless. I see no end to this suffering." To this, Mahadeva replies that the hereditary land rights have restricted the Mahas from doing independent business since they've been fed on the charity of others all their life. He asks, "What achievement can we boast of? All that comes from begging is more begging." The only solution that Mahadeva suggests is to get rid of the hereditary holding by abandoning it. The question that arises from this assertion is that if Mahas abandon the land right, then how would they survive? The grandfather Yetilia is convinced with the words of his grandson. He took out a few crumbs from his sack and threw them towards the dogs near his house. When his wife comes out, gathers all those crumbs and prepares with them. The entire family feeds on the prepared with the crumbs. The grandfather falls sick due to the food poisoning caused by the stale crumbs. The grandfather succumbed to his health and died. But the turning point in the story is the message that he gives to his grandson. He says that, "Never depend on the age-old bread associated with our caste. Get as much education as you can. Take away this accursed bread from the mouths of the Mahas. This poisonous bread will finally kill the very humanness of man." These words serve as a warning and a message to the new generations of the Maha community. This is a moment of Dalit consciousness, that is, the revolutionary mentality connected with struggle. It is a belief in rebellion against the caste system, recognizing the human being as its focus. Interestingly, the discourse in the story gives rise to the debate that is most relevant to the social and the legal system that has influenced the life of the Dalits and the underprivileged for centuries together. The land rights for the Mahas have failed to contribute to the growth of the Mahas, rather it has strengthened the position of the landowners. The land right has only weakened the position of the Mahas, who have become like the bonded laborers providing a lifetime service to the landowners. The title, "The Poisoned Bread," is about the stale bread that is symbolic of the poisonous caste division which has poisoned the society slowly. The story begins as a recall. This recall is remembering the unforgettable past. The memory is not an accidental remembrance of the past but is a conscious recall of a period that repeats itself like a cycle every year for 12 years. The incident took place at the time of harvest. Harvesting signifies a time of action when the yield is ready and the job of winnowing and treading out the corn at the threshing floor. Metaphorically, the grandfather is threshed out and the grandson is the newly formed corn, the yield from the field, that is ripe and ready for consumption. Similarly, so the grandfather's life is the cost he pays for the betterment of the new generations. The only thing that is comforting in the story is that the grandfather dies as a self-awakened and a consciously aware man, not as an ignorant, subservient servant of the landlord. This story brings out the problems of uneducated old villagers, particularly the grandfather who sees hope in future and advises his grandson to acquire education and defeat the age-old caste system. But the problem seems to be more serious than what it appears on the surface. Themes: oppression and resistance. Central to the narrative is the theme of oppression based on caste. The Dalits are subjected to a life of indignity, symbolized by the poisoned bread, which represents the toxic charity and false benevolence of the upper castes. The protagonist's resistance is a significant act of defiance against centuries of oppression, signaling a shift towards self-respect and autonomy. Identity and dignity. The story explores the struggle for identity and dignity within a system designed to strip individuals of these very attributes. The protagonist's refusal to accept the poisoned bread is also a refusal to accept the identity imposed upon him by an oppressive caste system. It is a quest for dignity in a society that offers none to those born into lower castes. Social injustice and morality. By highlighting the acceptance of poisoned bread as a norm within the community, the story critiques the moral and ethical decay inherent in a society that justifies such injustice. It forces readers to confront the uncomfortable realities of caste discrimination and the moral compromises made by those who benefit from or turn a blind eye to it. Literary devices. Symbolism. The poisoned bread itself is laden with symbolism. It represents not just the physical and moral degradation faced by the Dalits but also the corrupt nature of societal benevolence that is conditional and dehumanizing. Metaphor. The story uses the bread as a metaphor for the larger societal offerings to the Dalit community. Opportunities that are not genuine but are tainted with discrimination and exclusion. The act of consuming the bread metaphorically represents the forced acceptance of a lesser place in society. The bread in the story that kills the protagonist is virtually poison. But the real spirit of the story lies elsewhere, which gets articulated in the dying words of the old man. The bread is a variant of caste, in a sense. The bread is poisonous, if earned under a system controlled by slavery, but the call is to be free from slavery and the bonded labor. Chappal is a metaphor for the lowest status in the social order and caste hierarchy. Patil says to the grandson, "A chappal is never worshipped in place of God, is it?" The Mahas are treated as a chappal by the Patils of the society, signifying the lowest of the low, something to be loathed and treated contemptuously. Imagery. The vivid descriptions of the bread, its condition, and the setting of the Dalit community create powerful imagery that underscores the stark realities of caste discrimination. This imagery serves to immerse the reader in the protagonist's world, making the injustices faced by the community palpable. Symbols. Bread. In many cultures, bread is a symbol of life, sustenance, and community sharing. In this story, however, Bread becomes a symbol of the corruption of these values, representing the contaminated and toxic nature of the help and opportunities extended to the Dalits. Poison. Beyond its literal meaning, poison symbolizes the pervasive and insidious nature of caste discrimination that infects every aspect of Dalit lives, subtly undermining their well-being and dignity. Irony. Life-sustaining bread that kills. There is a profound irony in the notion of bread, which is meant to nourish and sustain life, being poisoned. This irony mirrors the broader social reality in which the very structures, social, economic, and political, that are supposed to support and protect the most vulnerable members of society instead inflict harm upon them. The offer of help is an act of violence. It is bitterly ironic that the higher caste's offer of bread to the Dalits, ostensibly an act of charity, is actually an act of violence. This reflects the twisted nature of social relations under a rigid caste system, where even acts of kindness are permeated with cruelty and contempt. Sarcasm. The story may employ sarcasm in its portrayal of the upper caste's benevolence. By depicting their charitable acts as both patronizing and toxic, the narrative sarcastically critiques the hollow nature of their pity and the self-serving manner in which it is offered. This sarcasm highlights the lack of genuine empathy or understanding from the upper castes regarding the Dalit condition. Sarcasm might also be used to critique the wider societal acceptance of caste discrimination as a norm. The acceptance and normalization of such a dehumanizing system are presented through the lens of bitter sarcasm, pointing to the absurdity and injustice of the social order. The writer uses sarcasm also as a device to underline the theme of the story, the plight of the Mahas. Yetalia's repeated requests and begging for some share of corn meets with scorn by Patil, who says in a derisive tone, "Don't give me that line, you're no longer the Mahamangs of the good old days, to beg your share of corn. You are now Harijan. You've even started claiming equality, so I was told, eating and drinking with us at the city hotels. So, there remains absolutely no difference between us, does there? Now that you are our peers, tell me, why do you still beg for a share of the corn?" This bitterness of Patil exposes the insignificance of the changing times and reforms in the lives of people like Yetalia, who are accused of forgetting the reality by their lords and masters and are shown their true position. The Poisoned Bread, by Bandhu Madhav, is a powerful narrative that uses the story of a young Dalit man's rejection of the poisoned bread as a lens through which to examine the broader issues of caste discrimination, social injustice, and the quest for dignity. Through its symbolic use of the poisoned bread, the story critiques the societal norms that perpetuate discrimination and highlights the moral and ethical decay such a system engenders. It is a poignant reminder of the resilience of the human spirit in the face of systemic oppression and a call to action for societal change.